Now we will discuss how to anchor safely. There is a procedure of anchoring in shallow waters and deep waters. Shallow water for the purpose of anchoring means less than 50 meters depth, and deep water means more than 50 meters. So first we will discuss shallow water anchoring, safe anchoring procedure. Ship approaches the anchoring area. On the chart, you already decide which point you want to anchor, and the ship heads towards that point. Once the ship comes to this point, speed is reduced, and when it approaches the anchoring point, its speed, roughly GPS speed, approximate zero. Half knot is also okay, approximately zero. And then the anchor, in the meantime, anchor is lowered till it is about 10 meters from the bottom. So it is lowered by gear till it is about 10 meters from the seabed, and then it is put on the brake. And once you have reached the anchoring position, then the brake is opened and the anchor drops 10 meters. And if you are facing the current, ship starts dropping back. If you are not facing the current, so here you can drop it 2-3 shackles or maximum 3-4 shackles and then hold on. If the ship is not facing the current, finally it will swing and it will face the current. And then the ship starts dropping back. Anchor is reached here. And ship starts dropping back. Now, once the ship has swung and faced the current, then you can use the ship's engine if required to reduce the strain on the cable. This is the water line. And again, when the GPS speed is roughly zero, you can again put it on gear and you can lower to whatever shackles you have decided, 7, 6, whatever. So this is the safest procedure to anchor the ship in shallow waters. Now, some people, they just lower the anchor till the water line and then drop. So here, what is the problem? The anchor drops, let's say 20 meters or 30 meters by break. Initially, the speed of the anchor is zero here. But once you open the break, it starts falling down, and every 1 second, the speed of the anchor keeps increasing. So here it might come to 10 kilometers per hour. Here it might come to 20 kilometers per hour, and finally when it hits, whatever, 30 kilometers per hour. Because we have dropped it at a certain depth of 20-30 meters. So when it drops with this high velocity, there are two problems which can happen. One is the anchor head, when it hits with a high force, might become damaged. And the second problem is, as the speed of the anchor keeps increasing, the RPM of this windlass also keeps increasing. So when the anchor finally reaches the bottom, this RPM is so high, it is difficult to control by the brake. Brake becomes hot, more wear and tear on the brake, smoke starts coming, sometimes fire also. So that is the problem. So this is the safest method. So finally anchor will drop only 10 meters its speed will not become so high, and this RPM will also not become so high, easy to control by the brake. And after you have dropped 10 meters and you have paid out 3-4 cycles more, whatever, after that ship swings, she becomes brought up, and then you can lower by gear. Now here the final lowering you can do by brake also or by gear, but gear is better because of two reasons. So first gear, then brake, and then gear. So this third part, which is only by gear instead of brake, that will help you in two ways. First is, there will be less wear and tear on the brake lining because you are not using the brake. And second is, it might take less time also, because in case the current is not strong, you open the brake but nothing goes out. So that is another problem. So this is about shallow water anchoring.